Because you see, I have the master parts list. It's all part of my master plan. The TM10 1186, July 1st, 1943. That's the master parts list, and that's got every bolt and nut and screw that you could possibly imagine. If you don't have one, pick one up. Hi, I'm Scott Schiller for Ron Fitzpatrick Jeep Parts and Team G503. Been doing a lengthy series here now of all the bolt hounds that are on the Willys MB tub, and we're getting really, really close now to having all the bolt hounds on. I can go back through one last time, give everything a nice scuffing, and coat it that final time with the OD green, and finally get that tub back on that drivable chassis that I've got sitting out in the garage. In this video, gonna be doing just a couple little simple things that won't take that long, but you guys ask where this stuff goes, trying to show you in great detail where it all goes, make it easy for you for your project. In this video, we'll be doing the horn mount on the firewall in the front, and we'll be doing the door strap eyelets on the inside of the dashboard. Check it out, I think you'll like it.
We're on the driver's side outside firewall here of the body tub, and here's the horn bracket, part number A1389, and notice there's a straight side on the top and a tapered side on the bottom, and you're going to orient this horn bracket as such on your firewall so the tabs are facing the passenger side, and I'll give you the measurements for the holes. Measuring from the straight side of the outside of the tub is shown here. The measurement is 1 3/8, and then draw yourself a straight line. Once you've got that straight line drawn, due to that curve right there, you'll have to measure on your straight line, and your first top hole will be at 7/8 of an inch, and the second one will be 2 1/4 inches from that. The hole sizes are 3/8 of an inch to accommodate the 5/16 by 24 by 5/8 of an inch long fasteners. And this is the first time we've seen the flat washers and any of the things we've bolted on the Jeep so far. And I'm wondering to myself, because I really can't find the information, if that's due to the vibration or the extension of the Spartan horn that I'll be installing later. I'll show you one more time here how this is installed. There's a flat straight side and there's a tapered side to the bracket itself. The flat side's going to go up top, the tapered side to the bottom, and we'll just go ahead and install the bolts here into the holes. And these are nice original bolts. These are the CTR marked bolts, and they go in there really nicely. We'll slide this inside those two holes, and the bolts itself should hold that bracket in there until we can reach around the backside and install the fasteners. Once we can go around the backside, you will install the flat washer first, then the lock washer, then the nut. Using a 1/2 inch box end opening wrench and a 1/2 inch socket and driver, I'll use the wrench on the outside to hold the nut because I'm going to clock or time, as it's been called, the markings on the bolts. It wouldn't have came that way from the factory, but I think that looks nice and professional. So I'll hold those markings in place and I'll from the backside tighten those bolts with my ratchet and socket. We'll do the same thing on the bottom one here, and then after I've got them nice and tight, I'll go back to both bolts and I'll give them one last nice tight snugging just to make sure that everything is secure and okay and they're not going to come loose. I don't know if you noticed in this video or not, but I painted the fasteners this time before I actually installed the accessory on the side there. It's just a little something I did because I had the original bolts. Now let's move along to the doorway strap eye bolts. There's two of them for the MB, and they are part number A2138. And if you notice a little indent there on the fold at the front of the cowl and the firewall near the glove box, that's the hole fastener that comes from the factory for these eye bolts. We'll insert the eye bolt in there, and here's the little trick now that I want to show you. On the MBs, the bolt would be installed vertically. On the GPWs, the Ford GPWs, it would be installed horizontally. Why this was done is anybody's guess. My personal speculation is that Willys and Ford were competing, and I think that Ford just particularly wanted something to stand out to show that it was a Ford GPW. Here's the fasteners. It's just a simple lock washer and a nut that goes on the back side. You'll have to reach in through the glove box here to install this. The lock washer goes on first and then the nut. And I'm going to show you a little trick here to get these straight so when you tighten them down, because if you tighten them back with a wrench or a socket from the backside, the eyelets have a tendency to move. So what you'll want to do is get yourself a wooden handle of some kind. I've got a small jeweler's hammer here that I'm going to use because it fits perfectly in the hole. And then you'll use that to kind of wedge against the eyelet as you give that final tighten to that bolt, and that wooden dowel will hold that eyelet in place in whatever direction you choose to install it. I'll show you the driver's side eyelet here and where it's located. And there's our passenger one. They're installed the same way with the lock washer and the nut from the back side. And we'll go into the cowl here, and I'll show you the locations of that lock washer and nuts right up there in the corner there where the cowl meets the dash. And then there in front of us here, get the camera straight, is where the lock washers, washers, and nuts are for your horn bracket. Hope the video's helped you out.
Actually, now there is a little something to that, what I just showed you on there too, because there's, you know, specific locations and fasteners and the way that those eyelets go and the way that that horn bracket is mounted. So maybe, you know, just these little pieces, they're all going to add up to one fantastic thing, and I'm really looking forward to that. If you'd like to follow along, we're doing the 1943 Willys MB project. We stripped it all down to nothing and putting it back together bolt by bolt, piece by piece. You can do so by hitting that subscribe button down there and also click that bell so you know when we've released new videos. Once again, all the parts that I'm showing you in these videos are available at Ron Fitzpatrick Jeep Parts, top quality parts at affordable prices at www.rfjp.com. Until next time, my friends, keep it safe. Happy jeeping.